Say America First. It's really loaded, and it raises issues about yet another dog whistle just before the midterms. Is this a calculation, or is this something less? Let's ask our great debaters. We have two great ones for you tonight, Anna Navarro and Steve Cortez. So, Anna, the president says, look, I want to help other countries. I just love our country, so that makes me a nationalist. Does that make you okay that he's just not using the word the right way?
Look, he also says and puts it into context and says, I shouldn't be saying that word, and they tell me I shouldn't be saying that word because he knows exactly what he's saying. And, of course, it's a calculated move because instead of talking about health care, instead of talking about the cover-up that the U.S. has been practically complicit in, that the Trump administration has been complicit in, of the Jamal Khashoggi murder, we are talking about his use of words. And, you know, it is what we've heard from him time and time again. I mean, if at this point you need to hear Trump say that he's a nationalist, if the fact that he questioned a U.S. judge's ability to do his job because his parents were Mexican immigrants, if the Central Park Five, if calling places like El Salvador and Haiti and Africa shitholes wasn't enough for you, then maybe you needed to hear him say this. As for me, this is ridiculous.
Maybe you're right. Steve, is that just the straight truth? Trump is a nationalist with all that word carries.
No, no, he is a nationalist. I am too, but you don't understand what it does carry. When you try to compare American nationalism to Nazis, for example, you're incredibly mistaken because the Nazis, their perverted nationalism was about racial purity. It was about blood and soil. American nationalism, which, by the way, defeated Nazism. American nationalism is about shared ideals. It's about a constitution.
That's not nationalism.
It has nothing to do with race, for example. Yes, it is. Well, by the way, you don't get, Chris, to just decide. Nobody made you CEO of the English language.
You know better than George Orwell?
That is nationalism to me.
Do you know better than George Orwell?
Yeah.
Do you know who that is?
Yes, I do.
Do you know better than he?
Yes, yeah.
Well, then why does he see
a
difference between patriotism and nationalism? Why does he see it as pernicious? Why does he see it as investing itself in these ugly concepts that you disagree with?
Right. My guess is he was talking at that time about specifically the Nazis. But what I'm telling you is that American nationalism, which has been a great force for good in this entire world, is about shared values. It's about our constitution. It's about our flag.
And why doesn't it just say patriotism?
Sometimes it's easier to describe something. Let me tell you why. Because sometimes it's easier to describe something by what it is not. And what it is not, and it's the opposite of, is globalism. And what Trump reacted against and our 2016 movement reacted against was the globalism, which was all too often taking control of America, where elites of political and media elites in places like Davos and the United Nations were making decisions for our country rather than Americans. And many of those same elites are more comfortable, quite frankly, with people from Paris, France, than they are from Paris, Texas.
So
American nationalism says
you see, this
Paris,
is what we
Texas
see.
Right.
First.
So, Anna, it seems like he's making the case that you were making.
This is,
nationalism means exactly what I was afraid it meant.
Listen, I think nationalism is a whistle for white nationalism. I think that's why Donald Trump said that there were people telling him he shouldn't say it. He knew exactly the message he was sending. And we see this, you know, from people who want to justify and enable Donald Trump over and over again. When we see him mocking a reporter, they say he was, I don't know, dancing the Macarena. When, you know, he pretends he doesn't hear the question about denouncing David Duke, they pretend the earpiece wasn't on well. When we hear him boasting about sexual assault, they pretend it's locker room talk. This is what happens over and over and over again. But his base understands this clearly. He sent the message clearly. That's why he said, I mean, why else would he say, I'm not supposed to use this word? He knows what he is doing. And what drives me crazy is that instead of of talking about the red tide in Florida, instead of talking about the murder and cover-up that the U.S. is allowing the Saudi Arabian government to perpetrate on Jamal Khashoggi's murder, after we saw the son being forced into saluting the royals there today, we are talking about this, another shiny object that Trump throws and that we have to react to, because how don't you
react
when the president of the United States goes out and calls himself practically, a racist?
Here's why he said that he should, that he's told that he shouldn't say it. And it's a shame we've come to this point, but pride in country and pride in America first has been unfortunately regarded increasingly by many elites who believe more in transnationalism and multilateralism than they do in America. It's become regarded as something retrograde.
You think that we're you think I just did what I did on the magic wall because I'm an elitist who doesn't like the idea of caring about your country? That's why you think I did Steve?
Well, the fact that you tried to ascribe American nationalism, tried to compare it to Nazi nationalism, tells me that you don't understand it at all.
Did I actually use the word Nazi? I don't believe I did,
movement.
And there's a reason I didn't. But also, let me tell you something. There's no such thing as American nationalism. There's just nationalism. Okay?
Well, there sure
and
is.
It's attached itself to different cultures.
There is American nationalism.
If you want to redefine it, that's fine. But let me give you a pro tip from politics. Don't use nationalism and try to redefine it. Find a new word, okay?
Enlightened American
nationalism
has been a great force for good for the world.
When creating cultural wars, Chris, why would they take that pro tip when dividing America, when fabricating culture wars, when making it them versus us has worked for Donald Trump in the past? He's going back to his old playbook, man.
No.
There's nothing new here.
American nationalism,
throwing out this kind of red meat and this racist dog whistling type of language.
Bannon didn't even call it American nationalism. He called it economic nationalism because he was trying to parse a little carefully. I don't know where you're going with American nationalism. That's an oxymoron.
No, it is not. American nationalism is about individualism. It's about free enterprise, about tolerance. It's about America's leadership in the world. And it's about a country that is not based on race, that's not blood and soil, a country based on ideals. And it's about also rejecting the idea that America, as the superpower of the world, should submit to the will of multilateralism. We've done that too much, whether it's bad trade deals, unfair security deals. And it's about America saying that the world is actually better off, by the way, when every country puts itself first, Britain first, Austria first, Mexico first. There's actually, ironically, more harmony, more prosperity and security for the world when we follow